trip to the 2014 Russell Athletic Bowl. We in the good city of Orlando have two of the top programs in all of college football as Bob Stoops' Oklahoma Sooners take on Dabo Sweeney's Clemson Tigers.
As the defensive coordinator from Oklahoma all those years, including the 2000 National Championship,
Ryan goes in motion. Knight to throw for the first time and threw it off target, nearly intercepted. It was intended for Shepard. Looked like it ended up behind him.
Had to go through with the ACL surgery after South Carolina.
Flanker screen. They get it out in a hurry to Scott and Artavis. Scott is off to the races. Scott, 65 yards, touchdown. For a flanker screen.
Yeah, Oklahoma's got to be thinking about that Oklahoma State game. So many missed tackles in Bedlam. As I was watching that game, I couldn't believe how many tackles were missed, and this is just bad defense by the safety. Quentin Hayes, who overwhelmed him, and the Eric Striker, arguably the best player on Oklahoma's defense, also took a bad angle from outside linebacker, and Scott, who's become a star as a true freshman, takes it to the house.
With the point after, and just like that, the Clemson Tigers explode with a close down to Scott touchdown pass. Is clicking on all cylinders. And they say they're going to run the same offense, but you're not going to get the same results.
Not here. This is different. This is just not having the running quarterbacks.
Blitz coming. Stop from behind.
People to get O'Brien for a slow down at all.
This will be a 39-yard drive by Lakin. And he snap hooked it.
Defense was offsides, though. Oklahoma jumped, and they're going to give. If you're an Oklahoma fan, you don't like to see things being re-kicked. Let's not forget that that is what happened when Bob Stoops decided to re-kick at the end of the game against Oklahoma State.
And it was one of their best on defense who was the guilty party, Zach Sanchez.
Offside. Defense number 15. 5-yard penalty.
Instead of 39, we'll try from 34. And he is true on that one. Clemson's had the ball twice. They've scored twice. And they're up 10-0 here at the Russell Athletic Bowl.
Ran right into him. And when you run into the guy, I think that's why they're going to call him.
Almost intercepted, and then it is intercepted.
Rin Wiggins, who was a linebacker who'd been playing out in space, and before in a play he had thought he had been held. This time Wiggins does an amazing job of reading this. This ball was thrown backwards. So even if Wiggins wouldn't have made this interception, I believe that would have been a fumble. And this is the one thing Trevor Knight has had real struggles with this year. He threw really bad interceptions against TCU, Kansas State, Baylor,
Oklahoma. Third and long. Blitz coming. And they got the step. From 42. Blocked. And Oklahoma has the football. That can turn around momentum. And Dulaway appeared to be the rusher who got a hand on it. Found a seam right in the middle for the block.
The turn of momentum because they're getting blown off this field. Very few positives so far.
Tip and intercepted. Picked up by Bowler. Bowler, 46 yards, touchdown. Through the hands of Shepard into the waiting arms of Ben Bowler, who gets the start in the first half because Stephon Anthony was suspended.
Not a terrific throw. Could have taken something off of it. Was a little ahead of Shepard. But what a nice job by Bowler. Good comeback there. Guy who's just a sophomore, was going to be a backup. Anthony, as you mentioned, was suspended for targeting against South Carolina. But you know what Brent Venables was just telling him right there? Go catch your breath because you're about to go back out on defense. That's the good news, bad news of scoring on defense is, hey, you still got to go try to tackle P. Ryan a bunch of times. So go catch your breath.
Well, if momentum had shifted to Oklahoma on the block, it's all gone.
It sure is.
Talent, he has both on this shootout. Number one in the country in total defense. They are equally as good against the run as they are against the pass. Shepard makes his first catch on his knees.
But is he MVP of this game?
7 carries, 12 yards for P-Rock. Knight, staying alive, got a great block there. And throws it out of bounds.
He got no help from his wide receivers. Gage offensive tackle at 6'6", 334. And he controlled the middle there.
How good must this feel for Cole Stout?
Haven't been able to get a lot of pressure with just the front four this year for Oklahoma.
Showing 5 on the line of scrimmage. Back out of it. Out for Humphreys, incomplete. Rhythm almost stride for stride to Stephen Parker.
Play that left guard position, which is where the block came from the last time.
This will be from 49. The 42-yarder was blocked. The 34-yarder was made. And this is not through by Ammon Lakem. And Clemson increases its total to 20. Nothing here in the first half against Oklahoma in the Russell Athletic. Knight changing the play. P-Ryan shifts. Screen to Neal. That's what a veteran defensive unit can do. And then thanks very much. Stout. Scott dragging the tackler with him to the 47-yard line. That'll be another first down.
I think this is a good decision by Sweeney.
Oklahoma may be offsides as well. This one's tipped. Picked off, intercepted by the offensive lineman, Charles Tapper. And Tapper is going to go for a touchdown, but hold the phone. It certainly appeared that Oklahoma was offside. Wouldn't that figure?
Unbelievable. We already showed what happened at the end of Bedlam, where Oklahoma had a running into the punter that they accepted instead of putting Oklahoma State on their own 15 with under a minute left. And now, a total game changer is going to come back.
Offside. Defense. The 5-yard penalty will result in a first down.
Okonkwo is the guilty party up top. Trying to get a good start. Boy, oh boy.
Yep. 3rd and 7 here. They're already well within field goal range if it comes to that. Underneath. In front of the first down, Williams breaks a tackle.
6 points. Yeah, give credit to Mike Williams, a big guy who had terrific bounce. Look to me like they may review this. There's an Oklahoma player down. But it did look like from the other angle the ball was in. If not, it's going to be on the 6-inch line.
Four touches.
It is confirmed. Good call by the officials on the field. Good speedy replay.
And poor tackling by Oklahoma if you're keeping score at home.
That caps an 80-yard drive that took more than 5 minutes off the clock.
And Mike Williams, a guy who had a tough start to the year, had some drops in that Georgia game, and just continued to work. I know we harp on the negative here, but just a terrific job of him to fight to the tackle, but also that drill of putting your hand on the ground, keeping yourself on balance.
And Mike Stoops, I think he's seen enough of this. Carry, just can't get past the line of scrimmage very often. Carry this time, and there he goes. Across the 20. This is 243 pounds of running back who has quick feet and speed.
Playing like they want it more than the Sooners right now.
Well, isn't that the truth? Knight back on third down over the middle and incomplete.
I think it's one of the reasons Chad Morris is going to be successful at SMU is I think he learned a lot while he was here about personnel and how to build a program that can sustain, because they clearly have done that at Clemson.
The blitz got to Cole Stout again, and that's one of the few things that Oklahoma has done well.
A lot in that one. The Florida State-Oregon game, that's going to be the one to watch.
Best field position so far for Oklahoma. Piron running hard to the 43, a couple yards shy of the first down.
The clock stops more often in college, the college game, than the pro game. I think he feels like risking some throws with Knight right now is not the way to get it done.
And anything on the board would obviously be huge. Samaje again, tripped up by an ankle tackle. A saving stop by Tony Stewart.
But go up and catch that ball.
On the season, Knight completed less than 60% of his passes. And in the modern college game, you need to do better than that. Piron, fumble! Clemson football. Piron had lost exactly one fumble all year long until now.
This defensive line, this time it was Grady Jarrett who came through completely unblocked. Jarrett just having a monster senior year, playing as well as any inside defensive lineman. Completely blows up the block, and he almost took the handoff. Piron did an excellent job knocking it out of his hands, but then Watson breaks his hand against Louisville.
Right.
Hurts his knee against Georgia Tech, plays against South Carolina, but then hurts his knee again. They decide to go in for surgery. So here's a guy handed the keys for his last game. He's playing great.
Really, his last chance to do something in a meaningful game, and he throws a strike to Sharon Peake.
He's going to chase on that side, so see what they do.
Third and 12, blitz coming. That pass may have been tipped as well, intended for Williams, fell far short of him. Knight under pressure. And Beasley got a hand on that. Almost caught it.
To call the plays, but wow, what a good night.
Scott shakes a tackle again. He's gotten away from Jordan Thomas more than one. So first down, Clemson. Scott on the fly sweep. Gets 9, maybe 10 yards before he's driven out of bounds.
Has never called and complained. Has always backed the decisions made by the staff and been very supportive of their son. What a nice evening for that family.
Stout with a keeper touchdown. Cole Stout to the delight of his dad.
What do you mean we don't have a quarterback run game with Deshaun Watson out? So, and you know what? I give the offensive staff here credit, because it's easy to say, you know what, he can't quite run it as well as Watson or what we advertised for him. But if you call it and he and he's productive when I'm calling. He had that same one earlier in the game where he picked up 7 or 8 yards. So you don't quite throw it out. You just don't put it as forward as you would with Deshaun Watson, but a wonderful play.
Well, he's not going to end up with 150 yards rushing.
But I think usually that means run the same defense. I like what you had that time. No reason to mess with success.
21 passes for Oklahoma. 38 yards. That's it. This one intended for Neal, off target, out of bounds.
And Bob Stoops, as that ball goes out of bounds, just shakes his head. Trevor Knight is just not been on today. I mean, who knows what can happen for Trevor Knight, but just a bummer of a way to have your regular season end.
Screen on 3rd and 5. Williams high-stepping it down the sideline. Another missed tackle. Oklahoma has to find a way to clean that up.
Over there, Mike Williams. They tried to throw it over towards that. Let's see if they go for a long throw.
Oklahoma coming on the rush. They go to Williams. And not only does he make the catch, he gets enough yards for a first down. They have
guys saying, we want to come play with Deshaun Watson. We know we've got a few years to come play with a really good player. Some guys like Baldwin, like David Scott.
Oh, it's coming. Touchdown. And Cole Stout was crushed by Dominic Alexander. Just crushed, but he hung in there, made the throw, and Hopper made the catch for a touchdown. Take a look at this replay. Boy, hit. Great job by Stout. That takes some guts to hang in there for that.
And I would hope, because of that hit, I really would hope that the medical staff would go over to Cole. This is one thing we have to do in this game, is watch when, even though he got up, even though he seems okay, I really want the medical staff.
Place mask. Number 19 of the defense. Play resulted in a touchdown. That penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
First place striker.
I don't think Stryker's doing anything dirty there. He's just going in to watch the play. But the way Stout's head hit the ground, I really hope that someone from the medical staff goes over. Just make sure that there wasn't a mild concussion. He seems to be okay. So there's a lot of ways to solve that, but those things are not easy. The players are doing it. It's tough to work. So clearly not coming through. We're up on the second.
Should this margin hold, it would be the worst Oklahoma.
Gary Peters said, really?
Breaks.
Really? You think we could be number one? Well, guess what they're going to finish this season as?
Fumble recovered by Clemson. You didn't think it could get worse? Yes, it can. Josh Wilson appeared to be the guy who knocked it loose from Keith Ford.
Especially early on, they just completely handled Oklahoma.
Young is a man in motion. Third and long, four-man pressure. Quinton will make the catch, and he's got a first down up near the 19-yard line.
Let's get Janine on who the pullback guy is. His technique is terrific. He knows to go to the midpoint of the person you're pulling back, so it's there. That's his former employer.
Off the left side, runs through one tackle, P-line inside the 20. Pushed out of bounds near the 10.
I get it, you don't want to get shut out.
Yeah, and I think you want to give him a positive feeling coming out of this game, too. They'll take it off the right side. They made it look easy with Ross. Alex Ross against that Clemson second unit. There goes the shutout. And Oklahoma at least has something on the board. Statistically, at least, this will not be the worst loss in the Oklahoma career of Bob Stoops. But practically, they're not going to look back on this game with any affection at all. That is tipped and no good.
that can.
And all Bob can do is shake his head. .351 left. And Oklahoma will go back to working on offense with a chance to put seven more on the board as Knight straight down the middle into double coverage, and it's picked. Nice play by T.J. Green. He had the underneath coverage, and they had him bracketed.
The secondary, if they want to get back into that elite talk for a playoff spot next season, and maybe you're after.
And it wasn't like Scott, as good as he was, broke a couple of tackles, and they just missed him. I mean, two guys whiffed, and the third had leverage on the outside and did his job. Bob Stoops, I'm sure, is still in a state of shock and won't be for a while. Clemson really handed it to him. Huge win for Dabo Swinney. 10th victory of the year. He's done it four times in his career at Clemson. Bob Stoops been to a bowl game 16 times in 16 years. Final 40-6. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget, live on the